Hey guys, what's up? Thanks so much for stopping by. If this is your first time here, welcome. My name is Dana. I'm so happy to have you. I'm gonna be sharing with you my first haul of 2021. In today's haul, we're focusing all on beauty items. I already do have another haul planned, so maybe we'll do that one next week, and that one's gonna be focusing more on just random lifestyle picks, Amazon favorites, home decor type of things. So definitely stay tuned for that one as well. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. That way you don't miss out on any future content. YesStyle is a site that I easily get lost in, sometimes just kind of black out, add things to my cart. I've mentioned this before in the past, but last year and the year before, I really got into Korean beauty makeup. I've been into K-beauty skincare for years and years. My mom is Korean. She loves Korean skincare. She swears by it. While she does use Korean makeup products, she tends to stick to the same like handful of brands, but when you go on YesStyle, it's almost like Ulta and Sephora. There's so many different brands, there's so many different products. Not only is it makeup, but there's like random home things too. No, this isn't sponsored. If you've been with me for a while, you know, I just genuinely love YesStyle. I think I'm gonna go ahead and start off with skincare first, get those out of the way, and then we'll go ahead and get into makeup. This is actually from a Japanese brand. I have yet to try this one, but I will definitely keep you updated. If you're not following me over on Instagram, I always like to share random and mini product reviews. This is the Habanayado, I have no idea. Hot Spring Series Bath Salts. So I got mine in milky. This one just sounded a little bit more hydrating. There were several different variations as well as several different brands kind of carrying the same product, but this was the brand that had the highest reviews. I'm not quite sure how this works, but not only is it like milky and hydrating, it's supposed to somehow make your bath water even hotter, which just sounds amazing. I'm one of those people that like to take my shower as hot as possible, my bath hot as possible. I basically sit in it and like boil like a chicken. I just love incredibly hot water. So this just sounded really interesting. Plus this time of the year, my legs, my skin dry, just like snake skin on my legs. I've mentioned this before, but it's like I can pull off my leggings and it's just a snowstorm. It's gross. So anything that provides extra moisture, I'm all for. So I'll definitely keep you updated. I love sheet masks. I use them religiously, but I've never tried ones that just come in one single carton. I see these all the time, but typically mine are, you know, like the individually wrapped ones, which are nice when you travel, but for just at home use, especially like when you wake up in the morning before you apply your makeup, I thought these would be perfect. This is the black tea hydrating. So once again, it was another option that had several different variations. I believe there was like a green tea one, maybe like a charcoal one for mattifying and pore clearing, but if there's hydrating, that's pretty much what I always go for. I haven't opened it yet, so it has a little seal, almost like a little Kleenex box, and it comes with little tweezers, so everything stays sanitary. I thought that was a cute touch. Oh, now get 33 sheets in here, so I'm really stoked to try those out. This is from the brand Rhodomentholatum. Isn't this the brand that makes those really cooling eye drops as well? Like the ones, I think Michelle Phan used to talk about them all the time. This is a cult favorite. This is a product that I see so many different Asian beauty bloggers talk about. So this is the Hada Labo Gokujian Hyaluronic Acid, like essence toner hydrating lotion. Some of my all-time favorite essences or hydrating lotions. I still rave about the Laneige Cream Skin Mist. I will forever love that one, but I still always love trying out and experimenting with other ones. Really excited to try this. It's a number one selling product, and it's one that I've had on my wish list for a while, but I just always forget to finalize and change it from like loves to add to cart. So now it's finally the time. I have a little bit more of my cream skin left, and then I will start using this one. This is from the brand Misha, which I've tried tons of different skincare from their line, but I'm pretty sure this is a semi-newer version of their Time Revolution. This is the Artemisia Treatment Essence. So it's double fermented. Fermentation is supposed to be amazing for your skin, just the way that it penetrates the barrier. It's supposed to be incredibly like hydrating, great for anti-aging. This was a product that I heard people rave about, and I went with the mist type. I just love mist essences. Obviously, it's easy to apply into your hands and pat onto your skin or go in with a cotton pad, but this already looks like it has the exact, you know what, let's just go over makeup. Yeah, this has the same sort of incredibly fine mist as the Laneige Cream Skin. I feel like all brands need to get with whatever manufacturer that Korean beauty brands use for mists, because look at this. The nozzles are always just perfect. Such a fine, even mist. I picked up one other eye mask. This is one of my favorites. You can order these on Amazon as well. You get 30 in here. These are amazing if you just leave them in your fridge. They're so incredibly hydrating. It's not a hydrogel mask. It's just the traditional plush cotton kind, but they are just soaked with all those yummy essences and juices just to keep your under eyes incredibly moisturized. I love this one. It's so incredibly affordable, but it's hands down my favorite under eye, like sheet mask, eye mask, whatever you want to call it. This is probably my 8th, 9th pack of them. I just adore them. I did grab one other eye mask and I actually tried these out today. They're not as moisturizing as the Pure Derm ones, but what I really liked about them is since they're so thin, they don't slide down at all. And it's really interesting with the very like thin layer of cotton, just melts right into your skin. It just disappears. As the essence soaks in, obviously you'll start to see like more of the white cotton, but from initial application, it just kind of disappears on your face, which is really cool. So if you're someone that likes to pop on eye masks while you're in the carpool line and you don't want anyone to see, you don't got big enough sunglasses, you could always go with these. Oh, I forgot. I did order one hair product. I'll go ahead and post a picture right here. It's a deep conditioner from Shiseido. Shiseido actually makes a ton of different hair care. Also, like within the Shiseido umbrella, there's other smaller brands, but I ordered this deep conditioning mask. Even with my thick and coarse hair, you only need a tiny bit. It is so smoothing. It makes your hair so silky. It detangles everything without weighing it down. Plus, it smells incredible. It just has that really nice kind of peachy floral scent. I'm really liking it so far. I've only used it, I think, 3 times now. If you're looking for an amazing deep conditioner, that one so far I am loving. Everything else in here is makeup. So I'm trying to think of how I applied everything first. Okay, pretty sure it was this guy. This is from the brand, it's Peach C, the brand. This is the Peach Glow makeup base. It smells really good, but to be honest, it swatches way more glowy and just like pearlescent than how it applies on your face. I think I've just gotten so spoiled with the VDL Lumi Layer and like the Assum 31, or is it 31 or 37? I always forget. The Air Dazzling Base, I find those to be way more glowy and pearlescent on the face. This has a very nice consistency. It does feel moisturizing, but I just feel like it doesn't look quite as glowy on the skin, but I definitely will continue to use it. From there, we moved on to eyebrows. I definitely messed up with colors on this. This is way warmer than what I expected, but this is the Holika Holika Skinny Eyebrow Wonder Drawing. I got mine in the shade 2. I'm guessing I should have went with like, normally shade 1 is black or granite. That probably would have been a better option. I've had great luck with the Etude House Slim Eyebrow Pencil. This isn't bad by any means. The actual formula is good, but the color was just way off. I was really interested in trying out a new brow mascara, brow gel. My holy grail is the Benefit 24 Hour Brow Setter, as well as the Maybelline Volume Fiberizer. I love those. I wanted to see how this one applied because I saw several different Korean YouTubers using it and it looked really nice and fluffy on their brows. While it does add volume, it doesn't hold the brow hairs up. And that's definitely just my personal preference. I love something that kind of gives you that spiky, feathery brow. That's the effect that I get from both the 24 Hour Brow Setter from Benefit as well as the Maybelline one. So I'll still continue to use this because I really do like the color that it adds, but it just doesn't hold up the brow hair. All right, moving on to eyeshadows. I ordered 3 different quads and then 1 mini palette. So a few years back, the majority of K-beauty brands made very soft, just almost like a light wash watercolor type of eyeshadow. That was a trend. I mean, it still is, but recently more and more brands have been coming out with intensely pigmented rich shadows. So I ordered 2 from the brand, I think it's Caradium. I had never tried this brand before. So these are the Bling Fit eyeshadow quads. The first quad is in the shade Moonstone. So both quads, or I guess all the quads, there were several different color choices, have the same layout. You have a matte shade, one of those more like sheer based glitter toppers, a satin shimmer, and then one of those pressed kind of, it's very similar to the shadows that are in the Huda Beauty palettes that have like the pressed kind of pearlescent shale-like pieces in there. I haven't played with this one too much yet, but rose quartz is beautiful. I didn't have any issues with any of the formulas. Now, I just wanted to quickly mention this kind of shimmer topper, just in case if you've never used one before. While there is a little bit of a pigmented base, as you can see, it's more on the sheer side. The main thing with the shadow is just to use more as a topper, whether you want it on a bare lid, just to have a very sheer kind of berry base or rosy base, and then all these gorgeous shimmer particles. It's so beautiful, just all over the lid, or if you wanted to use it as a topper just to really amp up any of the other three shades. But so far, so good on these. Like I said, I haven't used Moonstone yet, but it's swatched pretty much identical to Rose Quartz, so I'm guessing both are gonna be, or Moonstone will be just as good as Rose Quartz. One other quad, I had ordered something from Romand before from the Moon Knight line. The packaging of this is just so cute. It has this little sleepy bear in pajamas. Why is Asian packaging always just so cute? All their little characters I absolutely adore. But this one is in shade 4. There were several options in this as well. This is the main shade that I have all over my lid. It has a really interesting, slightly wet putty feel. You don't need any sort of base. It just glides right on. I would definitely recommend applying with your finger with a brush. You're gonna get more of just like the light wash of shimmer rather than both the glitter and the actual golden base in here. And then finally, this was the palette that I used for my crease color. This is from the brand, I think it's Corinco. This is #1 Shining Night. I was going back and forth on these swatches on their site. That's one thing. I will say sometimes the swatches, like within the Yes Style product info, there we go. Sometimes the swatches are way lighter than what you actually get in person. But in this palette, you have 3 mattes and you have 2 of those shimmery glitter topper type of shades. I really love this copper one. And then this amazing like garnet ruby red. Look how shiny this is. I've really been into mini palettes lately. Moving on to foundations. This is like a true sun BB cream. You know, these days you hear like BB cream and CC cream and you think of highly pigmented concentrated products like It Cosmetics CC cream, but this is the Pony Effect Prime Protect Sun Cover. I have mine in the shade beige. This is very, very sheer. There is some pigmentation in it, but it's one of those perfect products if you're just going for a walk. I still always apply my normal SPF all over, but you're just wanting to even out your skin tone a bit. Let's say you run into a neighbor, you just want to look a little bit more put together. This is the perfect product for that. I've had really great luck with Pony Effect. Sticking with Pony Effect, this is the foundation that I'm wearing today. This is the Everlasting Cushion Foundation. I have mine in nude beige. So this one came with the compact, the actual foundation, and then a backup. Most cushion foundations come like this, not all of them. Just make sure you really go through and read the description. This one was described as more of a natural luminous finish. They had a matte version as well. I don't find it to be quite as glassy and luminous as one of my favorite cushion foundations, which was another product that I featured in my yearly favorites, the Moonshot Micro Fit Cushion Foundation. That one is so incredibly dewy and luminous on the face. I love it. The coverage of this one is nice, but I definitely will have to play with this more. If you're just looking for like an everyday wear cushion foundation and you could find your shade, this does have a good buildable coverage, but I would say it's more on the natural finish side. And then I did grab one other cushion foundation from Moonshot just because I love the Micro Fit one so much. This one, I can't lie, I'm slightly disappointed in. I think I will like this more if I go in and mix it with something like the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Flawless Filter. This one is called the Micro Glassy Fit Cushion. I assumed that this one was gonna be even glassier and glossier than the Micro Fit Cushion, and it's not. It's almost matte on my skin. I need to go in and give it another shot, but the coverage of this is pretty freaking intense. I don't see anything glassy about this foundation though, which is unfortunate, but coverage-wise, it is really good. It just didn't give me the overall finish that I was expecting. Moving on to some bronzing or cheek products, I picked one up from iMimi. This is their #1 All About Contouring. So in here, you have 4 different quadrants. If you're someone that likes more of a neutral type of bronzer and you're heavy-handed, this would be perfect for you because it's a product you can really go in with a ton on a brush, and it's more of a soft, like natural looking finish. It works great if you want to contour your nose just with the shades in here. I've been using it a lot for eyeshadow too, just on everyday like light makeup days, like no makeup makeup looks. This was perfect. And then this guy here. Okay, I didn't do the best job of it today, but the first time I applied it, I did so good. I'm thinking maybe I need to go in and wash the brush because I felt like no matter what, I couldn't get it centered like I did the first time that I used it. This is from the brand 16 brand, which is actually made by Chosunga, which used to be sold at Sephora's a few years back. I don't know why they maybe it just didn't have enough attention or traction, but there's actually several products from Chosunga that I really like. For instance, their lip stains are so, so good. But this is the Filter Shot Contour Peach Nose Contour. So I do just have their original like contour powder for your cheeks, which is good. It comes with a small flat paddle brush. And then you have two bars of contour and then this highlight strip in the middle. So you're supposed to swipe your brush across and then just go straight down the bridge of your nose. Mine got a bit wonky today, as you can see from the demo, but the first time that I applied it, it was perfect. I actually really like this pink highlight shade in here. If you're looking for a nose highlight that isn't shimmery, like I know a lot of people like to contour their nose. I'm still kind of new to it. It's not something that I do every day, but this was a product that just really intrigued me. And the fact that it was finally back in stock, I was like, okay, now it's my time. I can finally try it, but yeah, there's definitely a learning curve to it. This, I absolutely love. Now, I've been experimenting with the Tower 28. I forgot the shade that I got. It's a lighter one of the two bronzers. I still haven't picked up one of their blushes, but I love the Holika Holika Lumi Cheek. I love cream blushes in general. If you like cream products too, I did an entire video talking all about my favorite go-to creams. I'll go ahead and link that here. Go-to cream makeup. I'll go ahead and leave that up above. This is the Naming Plainful Cream Blush. This is in the shade Benevolent. I have to say, I already like this more than the Tower 28 one. The Tower 28 one definitely has more of a tackiness to it than this Naming one. So you can just apply it with your finger or your sponge and tap it right in. And it's just such a beautiful buildable color. So obviously this is more sheer. You could go in with a bit more, but it's my ideal blush shade. I love anything just like peachy and slightly terracotta like this. It's just one of those gorgeous, like natural flushed looking cheek shades. I am interested in trying out more just because this just won my heart over immediately. And then on top of that, for my highlighter today, I went in with another product from Caradium. I have mine in the shade Salmon. You guys, this is so, so beautiful. If you love just that very like glossy, wet, glowy looking cheek, this is a powder product, but it's very thin and silky, so it applies great on top of this cream blush. I love it. It is such a cute and like happy color. It's one of those shades that works for all year round too. So loving both of these, but the combo of them together, dream team. And then finally, I just ordered two lip products this time. I have an overabundance of lip products in general, but for whatever reason, I always get suckered in on YesStyle and I order like a million different lip tints. So I was very proud of myself this time. So both of these are fluffy lip tints, which I just loved that name. I thought it was really cute. But one I would definitely call more of a gloss, and then the other is like a whipped liquid lipstick, but a very light, fluffy one. It does transfer though. It's not something that is like hardcore matte liquid lipstick like Maybelline Superstay. It does transfer, but the color is so beautiful. The scent is amazing. This one smells like one of those white peach candies that are just incredible. And then this one here is definitely a gloss. I don't know why they call them both the same thing because I find the formulas to be very, very different. This one is in the shade Moonlight and it's just a clear gloss with tiny flecks of shimmer. I just use it as a lip topper or on its own. I mean, it's not that special by any means because there is no color, but the formula does feel really nice on the lips. But if you're only gonna get one of these, I would definitely recommend picking up one of the colored shades if you could find one that you like. Oh, one last thing. This isn't makeup related, but I was wearing these on stories the other day. You guys were asking where they're from. I just wanted some new blue light glasses. I got these from YesStyle. I think they were like $2 or $3. So if you're ever looking for purses, wallets, I mean anything, home decor, chopsticks, cool utensils, random gadgets, YesStyle has it all. Also, if you guys are interested in winning a $100 credit to YesStyle, definitely stay tuned over on my Instagram as well as my yearly favorites. There's a giveaway going on in that video. And that is pretty much it for this. So as always, thank you so much for spending part of your day with me. If you haven't already, I would love if you subscribed. If you got some more time on your hands, you can check out one of these videos here. And that is pretty much it. So I will see you guys next time. Bye.